We're here with another deck profile with Julio Valls, who reached the second place Madrid Regional with Salamangreat, including a special engine.
Okay. Hi guys, I am here with my friend Daniel Fassi from Eternity Academy that had some ideas to beat the deck and I wanna show. For a start, the Salamangreat monster is too standard in general. I play one Gazelle, the Destroy Foxy, that is too important right now to destroy the last resort of a Spiral. Then only I am playing 2 Spinny because I am not playing rank 3. And that's why I'm playing the 3 Jaguar, because it's just a Spinny with more attack and level 4 that helps to make Davis Dueler. In other version I was playing the 3 Spinny, not playing the Falco, because the thing is just run the Salamangreat that are 3 special summon. For the other Steelers monsters, I am playing the 3 D.Va, the 3 Buffalo. And the 3 D.Va.
Yeah. Usually, most Salamangreat builds cannot run both 3 D.Va and both 3 Buffalo because they don't interact well together. You either summon D.Va or Buffalo, but you cannot usually run both in the same build at 3. But this card, that is this special engine that we are playing, the Code Talker, allows us to run both of them and to use them in the same turn. This card, what it does, it's you can link it from hand for the link summon of a Code Talker monster, and if you do, it adds a Signet spell or trap card. So it can add either the Cyber Spell, the Signet Mining, of course, that we run at 3, and also a Signet counter that is like an Orcus Crescendo. So it replaces itself in hand for the Signet, and also it summons this one that grants a special summon from hand. So you can first use Buffalo, draw cards, and in the draws, if you get a debuff or you have one of these, you can summon this one, special debuff from hand, add a card because it can add if a special summon, and also you have a level 4 to make Dweller or just to extend.
Also, sometimes in hand, you don't need summon the Inverted, and you can go directly for the transcode.
Yeah, it revives the world and it makes it untargetable with more attack, and it's difficult to break easily for some decks.
Yes. In general, all the people use this card for make OTKs, but especially in this version, it's just a monster reward for Flavors Monster that is just an extender. Okay, for hand traps, I am playing the 3-as. I was playing in 2, but in Salad this is one of the best hand traps. The 3 Crow, that hits all the decks in the meta right now. The 2 Schoolmasters, because I was afraid of the new Lunalight versions. Versus Spiral is decent, because they will try always to chain block the Master Plan Graveyard effect. Half of the tournament was Spiral. And that was, at least for me, unexpected. So for the next tournaments I will main the Drolan Glove. I play 27 monsters, 4 spells. I am playing the 3 pot. I like draw the pot with the D.Va, because with D.Va you can out of your deck the Field Spell and Gazelle. Also, if you banish Gazelle, you still have in place, because you can add the micro code with the D.Va.
Yeah, and it's still a free counter.
Yes.
It's actually what a Gazelle does. It gives like your counter and the code does too.
Now that the deck is just a link spam, this card should be mandatory at 3. Of course, the field spell and the searches of the deck. Thanks that this deck got more consistency, I didn't see great playing more copies of the traps. Because in general, if I want to go for this card, I can. And the Silent Conflict, that is a Orcus Crescendo for Code Monsters. If I control one of these, it banishes, integrates, activate of any effect, spell, trap, and banish. Also, he can activate the card for the rest of the turn.
Yeah, so like, Naked Master Plan, no more Master Plan. Even if they get an extra one, it's...
Exactly. That play that you comment was great in my top 4. I banished the Master Plan, and he just screwed. For extra deck, I play the 3 Veilings, the 3 Sunlight, 2 Hitlio, Phoenix, Ita, the Rank Force. Warlord is just because I am playing Dark Ruler no more inside deck, so the principal idea is negate all the spiral board, steal the sleeper, and attack the 3-3.
Yeah, also, it's pretty easy to make with the inverted code talker, which is special summons from him, because it's a link 2 that allows you very easy extending, and it's just there to make Boralow this way.
Then, they call the monsters. And the Abyss Ruler, that you can make easy in general in this version, because if you summon debuff, you can keep the debuff in field, make your place, and with the Jaguar and debuff, make the Ruler. For side deck, I am playing the 3 Droll, 3 Nibiru for Luna Light and Salad, 1 Bankra as a wildcard. For spell removal, I play the 3 Twin and the 3 Storm that I didn't draw in all the tournament, and the 2 Dark Ruler no more. Okay. That's all about the deck. Thanks, Dani, to be here. And thanks to all my teammates about the deck discussion, about the what hand traps are better or the side deck, and of course about the testing. That's all. Don't forget to subscribe to United Bossus channel, and comment if you have any questions. That's all. Goodbye.